BG,
what's going on, brother?
Why don't we stop being politically correct? Just on this one, let's just be correct, man.
You know I'm down.
This one's for the IRS in bed with the damn politicians.
And this one's for the boss, a horse that wouldn't let you off to go fishing.
And to the
six here. I haven't been uploading very lately because I've been kind of busy and pretty much I'm running low on depth, and I don't really like making videos when I ain't got no fucking depth. But guess what? I'm at the old gas station and I'm getting some fucking depth. You wanna watch? Favorite old gas station. Guess how much this shit cost in Kansas, West region I live in. Copenhagen snuff. Ain't that freaking beautiful? I haven't had that for fucking ever. Anyways.
Rebel Fun 86 here. It's been a while, but I'm back at you with another video. You can tell I got a little pinch of snuff in, and most of y'all don't know how to do it yet. And snuff's been out since like the 70s. Anyways, what you want to do, you don't want to pack it like that, because then it'll just spread out all over the bottom of the can, I'll show you. It actually packed. Hey, it's still kind of packed. I must have packed it real good last time. Oh, it wasn't that. It's most of people, when they pack up. They tap when it's coming up. I can't do it. Like that. I don't know. Some people are fucking retards. And yeah, it doesn't get packed very well when you do that. But shake it around a little bit and just pack it on the side's best pack you'll get. You can just do about five. And you pack it better, dang. That's a little better. And then there's like a wax on the bottom and side of the can. we want to do is go in there for the pinch. And push against the side of the can and squeeze the soup out of it. And push down on the top where it starts to come out. And then rub it against the side and the bottom pretty hard. And you got a little pinch of snuff. Snuff is about the nastiest, it tastes the best to me, besides wintergreen. But it gets all over your fingers and stuff, see that? When you're spitting for future times, you're going to be a little bit of those little black pebble dots. And you just want to spit that right over your tongue. Hold your lip in. Like that. And it catches the dots on your lip. You can move them back down with your tongue. Whatever I like to do, I like to take my fingers and push against my dip real hard on my gums and just, oh man, it's so good. Yep, got the old Chiefs flags and American flag behind me. Yeah, but anyway, maybe tomorrow I get paid, and you see that right there? That's where the stereo goes, and I might hacksaw that out and get me a deck and a mounting kit and a hookup kit, and I might be having me a new freaking stereo and the old pickup. Yep, that's what I'm doing tomorrow. I gotta go work first. It's not that bad, 6 a.m. to 2. I got the rest of the day to fuck off and spend some money, a little bit of money. Yep. All right, I'm either gonna do that or I'm just gonna do the head panel and put the dashboard back on because it's bugging me without it on. That is bugging me. I'd rather wait to put it back on because I don't want to take it on and off a whole bunch of times. Lose screws. All my screws to it are in the ashtray. That's where they're at. Don't you hate it when you're at work and you're told to go help somebody, and when you go over there to help them, they pretty much just watch you do it all? That's what happened to me the last 2 or 3 days while I was at work. They're way behind, they're way behind. No wonder why. She just fucking sits there and watches everybody else do it. What do you guys do for a living? I want to know that. What's your guys' job? My job kind of sucks, but it's really easy and I like it a lot. It's housekeeping at a retirement home. It's pretty nice. All the old people there are nice. They're like, you're the hard working little boy around here. I was like, thanks, old lady. Anyways, that's how you dip snuff. And where I learned how to dip snuff was from another YouTube dipper called Redneck TV. He's funny as all get out. He's very funny. go give him a shout out. He has like 20,000 subscribers, but I'll make sure that all three of my subscribers go follow. Okay, you guys go do that. And one of my old videos I made like a week ago, some guy comments on there, some city slicker, so one called Legal Pot in Kansas, that's the video. He comments on there, not all people in Kansas have a country accent. Well, dumbass, most people in Kansas don't, but some of the rural communities, like, Greensburg and some of them, they have a little bit, but the only reason why I have a little bit of a country accent is because I lived in Arkansas from the time I was about 6 years old till I was about 8. That's why. And whenever you're around that age, the people that you're around, like people in the city, people you know, they all got a little bit of an accent because they live down south in Arkansas. And guess what? When you're a kid, you're going to start talking like them. And you're going to talk like that for the rest of your freaking life. He wasn't really hating. He was just saying, I think he was trying to call me a fake country boy. What the hell is real country boy anyways? I know. Y'all are going to think I'm copying off Outlaw, but what he said was right. Country's not in your closet, it's in your heart. There's some country people that I know that listen to rap music quite a bit, but guess what? They're still country. You can't classify yourself as country. You either are or you ain't. You can't make yourself country. You don't have to be born in the country. It doesn't matter where you live, as long as it's in your heart. Country's not your address, it's in your heart. It's not in your closet, it's in your heart. Most of y'all don't get that because you're too busy out there being a fake son of a bitch. If I could tell fake son of a bitch from country, real country, I could, because, I'm country. I got my daddy's F-350. Brand new 2017 Power Stroke, something like that. I got my daddy's Duramax. It's been on the pavement all of his life. I'm country. Fucking mall climbers. I might do a little bit of a vlog tomorrow. When I'm on my way to the old Walmart and stuff like that. I might. Anyways, be looking for a video tomorrow. Rebel Flynn 86, and I'm out, y'all. Keep packing that can. Pack your can for Uncle Sam. And have a good night. See you later.